Hello, friends. My name is Cody D. Arkland, and I look after developer relations here at LaunchDarkly. Today's video, we're going to explore the concept of flag triggers. Flag triggers are a feature within LaunchDarkly that let you modify the state of a feature flag through different kinds of automation. A couple of those different ways you can use it are by having it generate a URL that you can call during your CI/CD pipeline. That pipeline stage runs, it calls the URL, and enables a feature based on something you've developed. Another way you can use flag triggers is by integrating it into your APM tools. So if you're a Datadog customer or a Dynatrace customer, you use flag triggers to automatically modify the state of a feature flag based on certain conditions within that platform. Let's jump in and take a look. Here we are within the LaunchDarkly portal. We can see a couple of different feature flags that I have in place. I'm in my default project right now and inside of the test environment. I'm going to drop into this login feature flag, and this is the one we're going to work with today. So I have my demo application up and running. It's just a real simple demo that I use to show off different features of the platform. Now, we're all used to the concept of toggling a feature flag, right? We come in, we turn this feature flag on, drop back into the application. Now I have a login box on the bottom. Real simple. But what if we want to have a system do this for us? What if I have my login component built into my CI/CD pipeline, and when I push that code, I want the final stage of that code to be enabling the feature flag? Now, this is a risky approach that you should really take with kind of care and caution, because there's different things that you might want to take into account. But if you wanted to be able to do that, flag triggers are an excellent way to get started. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to come in here, I'm going to scroll all the way over to the settings tab within this feature flag. And we can see this trigger section here. I can come in and I can select add a trigger, and we can see that I'm getting this menu now that lets me configure it. Now, if you wanted to go the APM route and bring this into something like a Datadog, I can hit this drop down and grab the Datadog link right here. You can see we have a number of different integrations that we can do within this platform. New Dynatrace, New Relics, SignalFX, Honeycomb, a lot of different choices here. And all of these providers will let you make changes within the LaunchDarkly platform based on values that you're getting back inside your application. This is a great way to start to scale the way you drive automation within LaunchDarkly. Huge fan of the concept. Today for this demo, we're going to use the generic trigger just because it's a fairly straightforward approach. So I'm going to select a generic trigger. And what I want to do is I want to have this flag turn on when that trigger is called. So I'm going to switch this to update flag targeted on, and I'm going to save trigger. And what we get back is a webhook URL. So I can copy this. And now, just like a good magician, I'm going to drop into my application, show there's nothing there. We're going to hop into the command line and call this URL and watch how the feature flag changes. So we'll do an HTTP call. We're going to do a post against that URL with no data. We can see I've sent that call out. We've gotten back a 200 OK. And if I switch back into the application, we can see that feature is released. Now it is at another trigger to go ahead and turn that feature flag off. We'll save that trigger again. Copy the URL, move back in the command line. We'll post it again with blank data. And we can see it's turned off now. As I mentioned before, flag triggers are a great way to integrate LaunchDarkly feature flag changes into your CI/CD pipelines, or even to bring them into any workflows that have the ability to call out to a URL. You can have your workflow activity run, and when it comes time to release those features, have automation drive that change instead of relying on an administrator to manage that change manually. Do you want to learn more about things like flag triggers or other features and functionality inside of LaunchDarkly? Check out LaunchDarkly Academy, our new learning and enablement website, where you can learn all of the new ways to use LaunchDarkly to launch better software. Make sure you subscribe to our YouTube. Catch you next time.